Hi, hello, hi. So today's video is going to be a little different from what I usually make. Anyone who follows me on Twitter knows that sometimes I fall down these rabbit holes of thinking where I will think about a regular, just like mundane thing. It could be a word, it could be a concept, it could be a bodily function, until said thing becomes completely foreign to me and is wild to think about. Today, I want to take you on this journey with me into the rabbit hole that is my abstract thinking, I guess you could call it. This could be anything, like literally just even the concept of pets. Let's say like my cat is sitting on my lap right now. There is a whole animal living in my house. It lives here and I feed it and I pet it and I like to, you know, I assume that it enjoys my company, but like I don't actually know that. Things like that. It's kind of wild the more you think about it. But today's video is not about my cat, although I would love if it were. Instead, today I want to talk to you about sensation. Now, what on earth do I mean by sensation? Well, so this morning, all right, I was making myself an espresso and I picked up my tiny, ridiculous glass espresso cup and I felt that it was cold. I felt that. My skin just told me the temperature of this object that exists outside of my body. Temperature itself is a wild concept, okay, but sensing temperature? That's just like, by touching something, my skin is giving me information about it. Like, imagine touching something and knowing what color it is. You're getting information about things that exist outside of your body through your sensory organs. I love it. Like, let's say even your sense of smell, something that probably seems mundane and ordinary to you, uneventful, even, we're gathering untangible and otherwise completely undetectable information through our sense of smell. You could locate something based on sense of smell. You could tell if something is burning based on sense of smell. You could tell if your dog is wet based on sense of smell, okay? Like, it's something that if we didn't have that sense, it wouldn't exist. And it's just, imagine all the other untangible bits of information that are just all around us that we just don't know about because we don't have the sensory organs to perceive them, okay? Like, that's just mind-blowing to me. Take your sense of smell and try to imagine explaining it to someone that doesn't experience smell and never has. Imagine trying to explain your sense of smell to like an alien species, okay? And yes, we're only a couple minutes in here, maybe 1 minute in, and yes, we are already talking about aliens. Strap in, I'm having a weird day. Let's reverse the roles. Let's say you meet aliens and they have a sense that you have never heard of, and they're interpreting information that you didn't even know existed. Let's say just by being in close proximity to you, that alien species could read your DNA. They could tell that you carry the genetic information for both blue eyes and brown eyes, even though you only present with brown eyes because brown eyes are the dominant trait. They could still tell that the gene is there. They could tell what your blood type is, because your blood type is also determined by your genes. They could tell that when you eat cilantro, it tastes like soap, because that is also a characteristic that is passed down genetically. This alien species, okay, is like the 23andMe of sentient beings, all right? Like, you meet them, and this is what they could do, and you're like, wow, that's mind-blowing. But now imagine, okay, hear me out, imagine if that same species didn't have a sense of smell. That species didn't have a sense of smell, and it blew their mind that without even looking at your dog, without hearing your dog, you could tell that your dog is wet. You could smell it. You could smell wet dog. You could smell a fire. You could smell if an egg has gone bad, even if outwardly it looks the same as any other egg. Imagine that, all right? Like, imagine if that blew their mind. Imagine if they didn't have a flesh layer that told them what temperature things outside of them were. Imagine if they didn't see the way that we do. If the concept of sight to them was mind-blowing. The fact that light bounces off of objects and into your eyes to give you information about that object from which the light bounced off of, like, I think that the 23andMe aliens would be very confused and or impressed. And I think you should be too, because I think sensation is wild. Now, rest assured, it is still I, Aaron N. Sweeney. I feel like this video makes me sound like I'm a demon that recently inhabited a human body for the first time, and I'm just like emotionally moved by every new sensation. Like, that's me, Tiger Self, folks. Life is wild. Life is mind-blowing. When you really stop to think about it, okay, when you really start to disconnect from your body and disassociate and think about concepts until they become untangible to you, things feel really extraordinary. And then like regular, everyday, issues. They're still there and they still suck, but I don't know. Sometimes thinking like this kind of helps me disconnect a bit from the things I have anxiety about that feel really big. And sometimes by making other things that seem small and mundane, making those things bigger sometimes helps me feel like my anxieties are just a little bit smaller. This might just be a me thing. It might just be like a disassociating thing. Honestly, I don't know. I just wanted to share this with you. Maybe I'll create an animated series about a very emotional demon who becomes overwhelmed with joy when he inhabits a human body for the first time and weeps every time he discovers a new sensation because it's just so beautiful. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think. I hope you have a great day and great week, and you take care of yourselves. All right, bye.